it's an odd question to ask whether it is a good time to do value buying. Value buying is a perennial forever exercise. Every time, whatever may be the state of the market, you want to buy quality businesses at prices which are representing value. In other words, at a discount to the intrinsic worth. That is what value buying is. And therefore, there is nothing specific about this time. But at the current point of time, I would only say one thing, that there has been a dramatic restructuring and there has been a dramatic reforms which have been unleashed, and they all seem to be combining together. Just to name a few, whether GST, which is aimed at cleansing the behavior of the businesses, demonetization, which was an effort at clean up the behavior of the individuals, RERA in the biggest but the murky sector like real estate, as far as the Insolvency Bankruptcy Act to clean up behavior of the large promoters and the industrialists who made it merry for a long period of time without really being accountable, and similarly clean up of the banks, which is setting the stage for more responsible lending and more responsible borrowing. All these are very powerful structural changes, and they kind of all have combined together right now. So these forces are creating material change in the character of the businesses, and these changes are not temporary, these are like permanent changes. And to that extent, what is interesting is the process of creative destruction which is at work. The bad businesses and the bad managements are either damaged or obliterated. On the other end, the quality businesses and the quality managements are flowering like never had before the opportunity. Therefore, bad capital and the bad kind of growth is getting retarded, and the good quality growth and the good capital and the good businesses and the good businessmen are thriving. This change is materially important, here to stay, and to that extent, all investing has to reflect that reality. Well, I think some of the most powerful reforms which have occurred, I already named. GST has been one. I would probably say it is one of the biggest reforms ever in the economic sphere. Demonetization, even though people debate and dispute about it, but I think it was a step in the absolutely right direction. The Insolvency Bankruptcy Act, RERA, the cleaning up of the muck on the bank balance sheets, these are all terrific big reforms which have occurred in the economic sphere. I think in the socio-economic sphere, building the toilets, building the roads in the hard infrastructure space, providing electricity, providing a clean fuel, and now effort to provide a clean water, all these are very vital, fundamental socio-economic changes which have a permanent bearing in the way the character of the society and eventually into the economy that will reflect. So I think the job of the government in substantial part, significant reforms have happened. A few more I would say, the one is on the land acquisition part. The second, I would say, on the labor reforms, which is still important and critical. It is a challenging connotations from a political, socio-political perspective, but that part means is a work in progress and is not yet done. I would also say the other important reform probably is on the personal income tax side. On the corporate side, a very powerful and huge kind of a deep reform which has occurred. Least expected, but a very powerful one. I would assume, as in when government finances permit it and sooner, similarly there is a reform on the private income tax side. These I would say, and probably last one would be on the agriculture side. In some sense, agriculture has been a holy cow for a long period of time. In Italy's time has come to introduce taxation on agriculture, especially at income threshold, defined income threshold level and beyond. There should logically be taxation on that part. I would say these are some of the more important ones remaining, but large part of the reforms have already occurred. Investing is a forever a lesson. I mean, all your life you learn, and all of the life you remain a student. The day you feel that you have learned everything or all the lessons, then probably markets give you a tight, rude slap on your face. But I would say quality of management is the first principle of investing. Never compromise on that. Capability as well as governance. Foresight as well as execution, good capital distribution as well as good capital allocation, all these are defining attributes of a quality management. Never flirt with them, never compromise on them. Equally, quality of the business is a huge, hugely important thing. Rarely bad businesses can create any value creation. Bad businesses, much like good businesses, have a predetermined destiny. Good businesses eventually have to be higher and growing, and the bad businesses eventually have to decline and die. And to that extent, any effort to make money out of the bad businesses is really a kind of a timing game which has not proved its efficacy over some more than three centuries of recorded history of investing. So flirting with the quality of management, flirting with the quality of businesses, and hoping to get away with either is a lottery, which is a chancy element, or is a statement of arrogance that somehow you will get away. And I think neither of that is investing. And to that extent, it is important to pay heed to these two vital aspects. And finally, I would say investing is less about kind of error of omission, and much more about minimizing errors of commission. Errors of omission, even if you missed out something worthy and worthwhile, it will not hurt you as much. You will find something else which may be less productive, less attractive, but it will still produce something meaningful if your process of selection is right and your discipline is right. But when you make a bad error of commission, it not only sets you back, but psychologically scars you, and to that extent it incapacitates you to do the right things going forward. Therefore, avoiding errors of commission is a fundamental principle of investing.